think about the environmental impact of using a lot of that over all of that coastline.
So many of the problems in the world that we're going to solve in the future are going to be solved through, you know, scientific thinking. And so even if they're not becoming scientists, that those ideas of collaboration, critical thinking, communication, it's going to tie into anything that they end up doing.
I can see the spots where it's collected the oil.
Yeah.
The absorbance works well, but
yeah.
I think it's only like a one-time use.
We are a STEM school, so we have the opportunity to embed STEM into everything that we do. It's super powerful because you look at kids and they're so curious about the world around them. And the STEM lens allows them to experience things and do hands-on learning. And it's not all on the computer, and it's not all from a book or up on the whiteboard. They really get to get into it.
We're going to define the problem, talk about the constraints, and brainstorm some solutions. And then,
so we're looking at real-world problems that often are scientific in nature. And as we're designing solutions and fixing things, focusing on that thinking to make the world a better place.
You'll see the scientists talking about the event.
So this morning, we watched a short video about the Deepwater Horizon spill. And then we started in on the oil spill test. So the idea was to see how much oil you could contain and recover from the spill, both in the ocean and then cleaning up the wildlife in the shore.
You will be attempting to use these items, six of them, to contain the oil, try to keep it from spreading, to try to clean up the water, shoreline wildlife as best you can.
So before they were able to start testing, they had to not just come up with a plan, but write it down and be specific.
I feel like the brown paper bag would really work, and probably the coffee pot
bowl. I think that helps focus their work so that they're not kind of just willy-nilly doing all this.
Once you have your six materials to test, bring your data sheet up and tell me what you need.
For their initial tests, they just had a single rock in one tub, a feather to represent a bird, and the pipe cleaner to represent a sea animal. And then the other tub was just plain water.
What are you saying, containment?
Poor.
Very poor.
And then, based on those results in the discussion, they chose three final ones.
We're going to use the baking soda on the rocks because if it's in the water, we can't clean it up. But if it's on the rocks, it'll probably be easier to clean up.
For the final test, they had a full-on baking tray with some rocks and gravel to represent the shoreline.
We should put the dish soap in the sponge,
but we need something that will scoop it up.
They added the oil into it.
That's like all of it.
It's stopping the oil from getting to it.
Yeah.
They ran the test, and then we had a discussion afterwards. What was effective, what wasn't effective.
The sponge and the cotton swabs we used. Because the sponge is absorbent, it's a little hard to get it off, but once you do, it's really good.
Students get to take what is happening in the world, and they really get to apply their learning to that. It helps them walk through that process of how can they affect change.
Yeah.
Oh, the cotton balls.